Photoshop makes it really easy to crop and straighten your photos. As you can see with this image, when we put it in the scanner, we didn't get it quite straight. If we go to the File menu, we can go down to Automate and choose Crop and Straighten Photos. From here, Photoshop makes a copy of your original, which is back here, and it tries to crop and straighten it for you. And it does a pretty darn good job. So for most of your photos, I would try that first to see if it'll work. Incidentally, that will also work if you have many photos in one big image file, and it'll separate all of them for you. But with this photo, we get a little white edge along the left and the bottom of the image. If that happens, then you can crop and fix this image if you want to, but you can also do the crop and straighten manually yourself if you need to. I'm going to go back to the original image and show you how to do this. First, we need to choose the crop tool on the toolbar. And from here, we'll choose the straighten tool. And we need to tell Photoshop what in this image is straight. That will give it a way to angle it or move it so that it becomes a straight image. Now, with this particular image, the background and the baby itself has no straight lines. So we're going to have to use the edge of our photo as a guide. So I'll click and hold my mouse button and draw a line down this straight edge. Photoshop then tries to make that photo straight. From here, it brings up the crop grid and you can pull it in and make sure you try to get a little bit inside of the edges so you don't have any white edges left over. And when you've got it the way you want it, you need to make a decision. Do you want to delete the cropped pixels or do you want to keep them? Now in this instance, I don't care about this white scanner area and the edges of the image with this serial number. But if you were cropping for composition purposes, let's say there was another little girl in this picture, you probably don't want to delete those cropped pixels. So make sure that you choose this check or uncheck box. For this one, I'm going to check it because I don't care about those cropped pixels. Now, you can do one of two things to commit this crop. You can hit the check mark button here, and this is also where you can come to cancel the current crop or reset the current crop, or you can hit the enter or return key on your keyboard. And there you've straightened and cropped your photo yourself. A couple of things to note with the crop. You can come to this unconstrained drop-down menu, and this lets you choose typical sizes. So if I wanted a 4x6 or a 5x7, I can choose that here, or I can choose a specific size and put it in here. Just make sure if I wanted to crop this to 4 inches by 6 inches, I would need to put 4IN and 6IN, or if I was doing pixels for the web, I'd need to do 500px by 500px, whatever it may be. And then this is going to swap those numbers if you need to.